Hi everyone, welcome to the fourth video for quantitative methods. In this video we'll talk about bivariate relationships. So these are relationships between two variables. Again, opening up Stata like we've done before and working from the CompuStat data that we've used so far. There's a few different things you can do to study relationships between two variables. One very straightforward one is what they call a scatter plot, which will simply plot the values for two variables basically next to each other. This is the scatter command. Let's say we want to cross-check how cash relates to year. And if we do that, remember the cash variable is called CH in this data set, the year variable year. If we do scatter CH year, you get this here. And what this shows is every dot is an observation in our data set. And here you see, for example, these are all the firms in 2010. And these are the values for cash that these firms have. So the highest value in 2010 was something around, say, 150,000 cash in whatever unit that may be. 2011, 2012, etc. And if we just look at this data set a little bit, you might see already in 2016, it seems that there's more firms that have very high values of cash. There's even two that have over 400,000. So this already suggests a little bit, you know, the nature of the relationship between what seems to be time and the cash variable. So it seems that in more recent years, maybe firms or more firms had higher cash. Something we will have discussed in class is the correlation, a value that can, a variable or a piece of information that can be between -1 and 1. -1 meaning that the two variables move oppositely. If year would go up, cash would go down in that sense. 1 being they move together perfectly. If year goes up, cash always goes up the same. If we check that, we see a correlation of 0.0116, which is actually quite a weak correlation, but it's positive. So it suggests that year and cash, they tend to move together. You can calculate correlations for more than just two variables. Just to illustrate here, this is AT, that's total assets. And here you see 0.7017 between AT and CH. That's a very strong correlation. So that suggests firms with more or higher total assets tend to have more cash as well. And then there's different tests that you can do in Stata to compare two variables in a sense. Quite commonly, you would see what they call t-tests and tests of probabilities. Those are comparisons of a given variable across two groups. So given what we've discussed so far, let's say we want to compare the cash values of firms in 2016, the end of our data, and 2010, the start of our data. And we'll use the generate and replace commands that we've seen in the prior video. So let's generate a new variable that we call year comparison. And let's say it needs to equal 1 if the year is exactly 2016. And then we use replace, given that there's all kinds of missing values right now. You see that here, 56,000 are still missing. Let's fill that in for the ones in 2010. So we'll have that equal 0 for the year 2010. So all the firms in that year. So if you just tabulate this right now, you can see there's many fewer observations than in our total data set because we will only be using 2 years. So there's 9,010 in 2016, 9,186 in 2010. And as I mentioned, the t-test is a very common test that people would do to compare the average values of a variable by a certain group, here being the year 2016 or not, or 2010. And the way this command works is t-test, you say which variable you want to calculate the averages for and compare them, and then between parentheses for the by subcommand or the by option, you specify the group. So here we say by year comparison, the one we just generated. And if you run this, you get this table here showing that for the 7,000 firms in 2010 with a value for cash, because remember there were a lot of missing observations for cash, the average was about 604. For the ones in 2016, that's this number of observations, the average was about 873. So this seems to be higher, but it's not really statistical evidence just yet. What we need to look for is this p-value, which is also something we'll discuss in class. And what we'll have discussed there is that if a p-value is below 0.05, commonly people would conclude that there's statistical evidence that there is something of an effect. Depending on the test we do, this will mean different things. In this case, it is indeed lower than 0.05, and this implies for a t-test that there's a difference between these two groups. Because this one is larger than this one, it implies that firms on average have higher cash in 2016 than they do in 2010. Again, note that not all the observations are used from our data set, given that we don't have cash for all these firms. One thing to note is that t-tests, they assume that the two groups that you're comparing have an equal variance in the two groups that you compare. Looking at these standard deviations, it's quite clear that this is probably not the case, because this standard deviation is much larger in 2016 than in 2010. And because the variance is the square of the standard deviation, this implies also that the variance will likely be quite a bit bigger. To check this officially or statistically, you can use the SD test command. And doing that similar to the setup for the t-test, we say we want to do the SD standard deviation test for the CH variable by these two groups that we just calculated. Running this, we indeed see a very, very small p-value, indistinguishable from zero pretty much, 0.000, and this indeed confirms that the standard deviations and by extension the variances are not equal in these two subgroups. In other words, the t-test that we just did is not quite correct. We need to make a small change to the command. Specifically, we'll have the t-test as it is here, but we'll add the option unequal. This will correct the t-test for this violation of the assumption that the variance was equal between these two groups. And indeed, you now see slightly different information, but the core logic is still the same, because we again get a p-value, which, as you might see, is slightly different but pretty similar, and is still showing statistical evidence, given that it's smaller than 0.05, that the average cash in 2016 is higher than the average cash in 2010. Another thing you can do is compare groups between groups. So let's say we want to see if in 2010 there were more firms in the US than in 2016. For this, we'll use the LOC variable that we also saw briefly in the last video to generate a new indicator showing a firm is in the USA or it is not. Recall that there were many, many different countries in our data set. We are just now combining it into another group of all the countries versus the US. We're going to do generate USA equals 1. If the location variable is exactly the same as USA, which was the code that we had in the data, and we'll replace those missings with a zero if location is not equal to USA, this exclamation mark equal being not equal to. And now we can use what they call the test of probabilities, and that's going to calculate how much percent of our observations are in the group with a one, in this case being USA, and compare that across the years in this case. So typing PR tests and then the variable that we want to compare it on, so PR test USA, and then by year comparison, similar to the t-test and the SD-test that we saw, we'll now do this comparison. And what you get out of here then is for the ones in 2010, that's for the zero group, you see that 85 or 86% was in the US. In 2016, that's the one group for the group that we compare it on, that's about 85.3%. So clearly this is not a very big difference. And then indeed, if we look at the p-value here, we see it 0.297. By no threshold would this be statistically significant. In other words, this particular test has shown that in 2010 and 2016, we don't see more or less US-based firms. So these are some of the more common bivariate tests that you might use, by far the most common one being the correlation. In further videos, we're going to make things a little bit more advanced by moving to multivariate statistics. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you soon.